Conventions aren't the only big money makers for our city. Did you know that the city owns a major railroad network? News4's Brian Hamrick takes us for a ride of Cincinnati's best-kept secret.
An economic crisis has forced city leaders to take unprecedented steps, something no city has ever done before, in fact. Sink millions and millions of dollars into a single project to stimulate the economy. Maybe you haven't heard of the plan because it was finished 130 years ago and is still working.
Few things are as noisy or as long running as this 446-mile secret.
Well, it's sort of the best-kept secret in town.
This is the Cincinnati Southern Railway, a rail line that runs from downtown to Chattanooga, Tennessee. And the city is more than a starting point. Cincinnati is also the owner.
When you tell people about this rail line that the city owns, what's the general response?
What? They don't know.
Tom McCohen is a trustee on the railway board. He says it's the only rail line in the nation built and owned by a city.
I would not be surprised if this wasn't the largest public works project of any city.
But what makes this such a huge economic engine is how much money the city makes leasing the rail line to Norfolk Southern every single year. It's oil well-like profits.
Last year it was $19 million, and so that would be a big hole if we didn't get that.
Roxanne Qualls is city council member and former mayor. She tracks the train money.
It is part of the money used to make sure that we fulfill the requirements for investing in infrastructure.
The idea for a railway to the south came after the Civil War, as city leaders realized steamboats were passing by Cincinnati, going to Louisville because they had a rail line.
Fortunately, the city fathers were smart enough to do something.
Jack Happ with the Cincinnati Railroad Club watches from the old Union Terminal Control Tower, a good place to see the line that was finished in 1879 and is more active than ever.
I don't know how many trains a day, but we see, I bet you, at least one train an hour coming or going.
It's been a journey 130 years long and is far from over.
Another line of trivia, the first train to pull in down on the other end of the line in Tennessee was dubbed the Chattanooga Choo-Choo. Should have been the Cincinnati Choo-Choo. Brian Hamrick, News 5.